Welcome back. Here is another very important question. Please read through the question carefully, and you may like to pause the video meanwhile and solve it. Okay, I hope you have tried to solve the question and have found your best answer out of the multiple choices. Let us see what is the best answer to this question. First of all, we must find out what data is provided in the question. Number two, what assumptions are given in the question? Number three, is there any such info or data which has been left out by the examiner? After collecting this information, when we try to solve the question, we will hopefully come up with the best possible answer. Now let us see what is given in this question. In this question, we have 10 number of PV modules which are connected in series. So 10 number of PV modules connected in series are making a system. We have 10 modules and connected in series. Each of these modules have following characteristics which are given here, and we need to find out the expected voltage and current output of the system. Remember, the question is asking for the system. Under what conditions? First, we have standard test conditions, which is STC, and the other information is given that the inverter and PV are operating ideally and sending power to the load. So ideally means there are no losses. Okay, we have all the information from this question, and now we need to find out what is the voltage and current output of the system. Okay, we have PV modules connected in series, and we need to find out what is the output current. We know that in a series connected system, the current produced by one module is the same for all the modules. So we are dealing here with the standard test conditions. Under standard test conditions, for a given specifications which are here, all this data, we can see that we are given VOC, open circuit voltage, VMP, maximum power voltage, and this info is a little tricky, power 340 volt. Remember one thing is that when a specification is given about a PV module under standard test conditions, then the power is always the maximum power of that module under standard test conditions. What does this mean is that if the power is 340 watt, then the voltage shall be 38.2 volts. So we have power here, 340 watts, and we have maximum voltage 38.2. So under standard test conditions, the module is operating at or delivering 340 watts, and it shall be at the voltage 38.2 volts. So what does this mean? This means that all the connected series modules 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10, they will add up the voltage, number one. Number two, the current produced by one module will be same for all the module. So we need to find out what is the current produced by one module, which is very easy here. We can see that IMP, the maximum current under these conditions, which is power 340 watt and voltage 38.2 is, you can see 340 divided by 38.2 is equal to 8.9 ampere. Let us see a typical data sheet of a PV module. Here we have a data sheet from Trina Solar, Tall Max Plus model. And out of this, we have selected this one, which shows that the peak power watt or the Pmax WP is 340 watt. This means that under the condition when the module is delivering 340 watts, the voltage of the module produced shall be 38.2 and the current produced shall be 8.9, which we have already calculated. So coming back to our slide, we can see that the maximum current produced by the system is 8.9 ampere. And what shall be the voltage? For a series connected PV modules, the voltage of each PV module shall add up for all the modules. So here we have BMP 38.2 and we have 10 number of modules, so we shall multiply to get 382. So our answer to this question is that the voltage of the system is 382 volts and ampere 8.9 amperes, which is the first choice here. Our best answer is here. Before I conclude this question, let us see the IV curves of PV module just for general understanding and PV curves of PV module. Under STC conditions, the module shall be operating at 1000 watt per meter square. In this curve, you can see that the open circuit voltage is here and the short circuit current is here. So we know from the data given in the question that the BMP, which is 38.2, which essentially falls almost here. So our maximum operating point is here. Similarly, on the PV curves, we can see that on the 1000 watt per meter square curve, the 38.2 is almost here, which is obviously the maximum power point of this module. So in order to find out the missing data like current or voltage, we must find out that what are the standard conditions and what data is provided here, and simply with the given data we can find out the missing parameter. In this case, we have found out 8.9 amperes current for the system and 382 voltage for the system voltage.